And now, the testing procedure for the bone sample. Using a caliper, measure the sample diameter twice at the middle position where the loading pin will be applied, by measuring the diameter of the narrowest part of the bone and the thickest part of the bone, and report the value. Then, place the rat femur sample on the supporting pins to estimate the span. Then adjust the distance of the pins by sliding the three-point bending supports after unscrewing their securing screws. Report that distance as the span length. Reposition the rat femur sample on the supporting pins and make sure that the sample is properly aligned. Using manual controls, lower the stage at medium speed to approximately 20 mm above the sample and at low speed to approximately 2 mm above the sample. Then perform the following test sequence to find the surface of the sample. A zero load, followed by a fine contact, with position Z as the stage axis, the force in the Z direction as the load cell axis, and this test will be performed in the positive direction at a velocity of 0.01 mm per second, a contact criteria of 5 gram force, a stage limit of 3 mm, and a stage repositioning of 2 times the load cell resolution. We will not save the data. Then we will insert a zero position function with position Z as the stage axis parameter. We can now execute the sequence. Then proceed with the bending test using the following sequence: a zero load, followed by a move relative, with position Z as the stage axis, with an amplitude of 10 mm at a velocity of 0.1 mm per second. We will save the data as group number underscore team number underscore bending underscore bone. Remove the zero position from the sequence and then execute the test. Then, using manual controls, raise the stage to approximately 50 mm above the sample. Using a caliper, measure the wall thickness of the cortical bone after the femur has experienced failure and report the value. You can now dispose of the sample.